मिस्टर संजय देशमुख, डॉक्टर दीपेश रेड्डी, मिस सईदा कीर्तने, डॉक्टर बोकानी, ऑल दी डिस्टिंग्विश्ड डॉक्टर्स and participants who have assembled here for this round table on diabetes. At the outset, let me congratulate Mr. Kulkarni and his team of the Observer Research Foundation and also the Municipal Corporation of Mumbai for having taken this initiative to organize this round table here. I was fortunate to hear quite a few experts, some of them from our Municipal Corporation hospitals, some of them from organizations who are involved with the work in diabetes. And it gives me real pleasure to be here. A health minister basically has to be like a general practitioner. I cannot be somebody, like you say, specializing in one particular field, because I have to deal with various groups, and it's good to know that in Mumbai and in our state, we have organizations, we have individuals who have taken interest in different health issues, individuals as well as NGOs. There is a huge group of people working for HIV/AIDS for a long, long time. There are people who work in blood-related issues like thalassemia, sickle cell, oncology-related issues like isotomy, and so many others. And Mr. Kulkarni, if I'll have to wear a badge like this, my whole chest will be full of badges. It's one thing very interesting about all these people who work in the health sector. We have to really admire them. Some of them are involved in these projects because some member of their family is affected by the particular type of illness. And there are NGOs who are involved in various projects, and the amount of good work they put in and the feedback which they give the policy makers like us or the commissioners who are sitting in the corporation or in the government is huge. And this is what helps us formulate policies for the state. As far as diabetes is concerned, I want to tell you that I started this program, huge program for sickle cell, about 6 to 7 years back when I was Minister of State for Education, Medical Education. This sickle cell problem is basically, it was in the tribal areas, in Vidar. We got our medical colleges involved in conducting a survey to find out patients of sickle cell. In a small way, we started with Nagpur Medical College. And when we started that process of for the sickle cell, we found out that most of the tribals were also diabetic. And then when I asked my officers, they were also surprised because diabetes was not very prevalent those days, 5-6 years back or 10 years back among the tribals. But now the picture has changed. Even in that community, diabetes is going up. Rate of diabetes is going up. Then the sickle cell, now of course the sickle cell is a huge project all over Maharashtra. And also when we do blood checkup for HIV or blood checkup for all surgeries in government hospitals, or when the lady comes for delivery. Diabetics is one of the things which is still we try to find out if they are affected by diabetes. It is going up. The rate of people suffering from diabetes is definitely going up all over the state. And we have, as Daksha said, the national program action plan has been formulated in 12-13 for non-communicable disease. And we started off with the, I think, 6 districts in Maharashtra. We started off in Vidarbh. We covered Wardha, Chandrapur, Bhandara, Amravati, Vasim. Now we have taken 5 more districts from Western Maharashtra. So altogether 11 districts we have taken up under this action plan for diabetes. That is not only surveillance but also treatment and counseling. Now you all are all experts here, you all discussed everything possible under the sun about diabetes. The main important thing is prevention. Some of you mentioned we have also trying to involve the youth and cultural affairs ministry and the school education ministry in this program, so that even in schools we start this awareness campaign. And even in the youth affairs ministry we are planning to take up this awareness campaign. As Dr. Chadha said, that drugs are available in the market, plenty of drugs are available, but it's beyond the means of common man. Even if you're a, what you say, a middle class family, today drugs are beyond our, see, the prices of drugs are going up day by day. We have taken a decision in the state of Maharashtra to provide free drugs all over Maharashtra, except in Mumbai, Pune and Nagpur. What we have done is, we had an expert committee formed and we have shortlisted something around 440 drugs. That includes all drugs for diabetics. All drugs related to oncology, all drugs related to hypertension. And this will be given in government units, right from a PHC to a district hospital, absolutely free of cost, irrespective of the income of the family. The diabetic drugs will start distributing them by next month. That includes insulin, also will be provided free of cost. That's one major step we have taken as far as drugs are concerned. And when I said Mumbai and Pune, Nagpur is not included in this program, because we took it up jointly with the government of India under the Rural Health Mission. And what funds we got, because the health minister and ministry in Maharashtra doesn't have much of a role to play in the metro cities. Because the whole department, health department, is the municipal corporation. But now with the urban mission coming into play, what was earlier NRHM, Rural Health Mission, it is redefined as the National Health Mission. So it combines both the urban areas and the rural areas. So in the last month, I think to April, we got some money from Government of India. We have already forwarded the money to various corporations, and there will be a committee under the municipal commissioner in all metro cities, and all cities and towns which will have a population of more than 50-60,000. So now the Government of India and the Government of Maharashtra will be funding this municipal corporations for health related issues, upgradations of PHCs, taking up national programs like the communicable disease, upgradations of maternity homes, because reducing infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate is also one of our key programs under NRHM. And I'm really happy to inform you that today Maharashtra, in the last 3 years, we are in the top 3 states in the country who have reduced infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate. Now after Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Maharashtra, we are in the top three bracket. And as far as institutional deliveries is concerned, we are number one in the country. We have 95% institutional deliveries taking place in the state of Maharashtra. And out of that, you will be surprised, 50% is in government and municipal corporation hospitals. That number was very low earlier. People should not come to a municipal hospital or a government hospital for a delivery. But now that number has gone up from 35 to 50%. That means our municipal corporation hospitals are doing good work. Our government hospitals in rural areas are doing good work. You will be surprised, Mr. Kulkarni, when I went to Ichel Karanji for a visit, some people came and met me. He said, Sahib, ek kaam karana tumse hospital madhe, rooms kara, private rooms, and we are ready to pay. We don't mind getting our daughter-in-laws and daughters for delivery in your hospital, but we don't want it free. I asked them, why do you, when we are giving it free, it's a national program, I said. We pick up the lady from the house, we get her to the hospital after delivery, whether it is a normal delivery or a cesarean, we give everything free, food, drugs, blood, everything, and drop you back with the child. Transport is also free. He's saying, no, my daughter's in-laws will not like it. They will ask me, why did you admit our daughter-in-law in a government hospital? You should have done it in a private hospital. So they said, why don't you charge? So we can tell them, no, the government hospital also charges notice. I think Mumbai Municipal Corporation has taken a very good initiative as far as diabetes is concerned. There are so many other things also Mumbai Municipal Corporation needs to take keen interest on. Besides, malaria was a huge problem for us 4 years back, and I know how we tackled it. The other problems are all waterborne related. Sometimes as the health minister, I myself wonder how we exist in the city of Mumbai. It's not only the roads which you can't walk, but the health minister has himself got a serious neck problem because of driving on this one. You know, the density of the city itself is so huge, and it becomes so very difficult for the policy makers or the administration to do anything. If you come to my constituency in Andheri and visit one of the slums, you know that we are sitting on an atom bomb. I arranged the ward office to send the garbage van thrice a day to pick up garbage. But then even that is insufficient. In one spot, the number of garbage disposal in the city of Mumbai, he will tell you, it's a huge, huge issue, but corporation is trying to do something. Water, safe water. I went for a program to Tata Memorial Hospital, and the director was telling me, sir, if you take up only one program, that is to provide pure drinking water to the citizens in Maharashtra and good sanitation, 50% of your health budget you can save. It's a fact. He says 90 to 95% of cancer related disease is because of people don't get pure water and because of unhygienic conditions. So we have to concentrate when we talk of prevention. There's a whole lot of disease, and every year you find some new virus coming into this thing, and then the doctors and scientists have to. They are also lost now. So we start naming them with alphabets and numbers now. It starts from H1N1 and it will go on. What we think, what I feel is, when we talk of health and the other activities like drinking water, sanitation, garbage disposal, all this will have to go hand in hand. If we cannot provide good potable drinking water, if we cannot create awareness amongst our citizens to maintain the neighborhood, the cleanliness, then all our efforts in whatever campaign, you go for walks, you go for jogging, you do what you want, but if your environment is not clean, you will land up in a hospital, you will have to go to the doctor for something or the other. So I think what is more important is when we talk of one particular health issue, we also should also talk about the environment, also talk about drinking water. It should be all correlated. I wish all of you the very best. I have some commitment in Andheri. I was in Andheri, I came back, came here for this program. I have to rush back again. It would have been great if I had more time and could have sat with you and heard all of you. I congratulate all of you and I hope you all will continue to do this good work in our city. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.